May the 21st after the market close, and we start off looking at a chart of SPX here. And what we have here was Friday, and we had a slam dunk here down all the way. It was option expiration, and the market was just being oversold here. But today, as the market opened here, due to several things that happened overnight over the weekend, the G8 meetings, which have a lot of assurances for Greece in bailing them out and keeping them in the eurozone and attaching information and giving assurances to the financial market, helped the market open this morning with a great ferocity to the upside. Also, the market was technically oversold, and that reason itself was there to bring on some kind of a technical bounce. Number third thing was that China's minister said the growth is gonna be much better, and so those news all filtered in, and when the market came, the futures were trading higher from the very beginning in the morning when I got up, and then they climbed all day long, and we finished the day here. But what is interesting to look at it here in this study is that we are still in that channel, and we have not violated that upper trend line that is sitting there. The stock market, SPX, has to take out that trend line in order to advance and call it a trend or break down this downside to the action, because it can go up here today and tomorrow it reaches a little bit higher and then slams down again to $1,300 levels. So that is a great amount of possibility the bears will jump on it, because this thing is still in that downward channel. Now I'm going to put another study here, which is called the EMA bands, Bollinger bands, and you can see what is really transpiring here. Let me see if this allows me to put that study. Here it is. You look at this. This is a Bollinger band EMA, and as the price was coming down here, it was tagging the band very hard. Whenever it does that, it bounces off and goes to the mean, which is right here, about 1360, 1350, and it may very well bounce off here and not come back. But we don't know that, and this action is definitely of technical bounce, hitting the Bollinger band. When the band starts piercing, it always bounces here. You can see here the price was hitting the band and it moved down here. The same action is happening here. Can we go up higher? If we take out 1330 tomorrow, then we're in a good shape here. Let's go back to the studies here and put our studies here, McKellen oscillator, and let's see, that thing is gone, and see where the reading are. Now remember, we had a last video, the McKellen oscillator was reading minus 338. Today the reading is now 177, which is a lot fair. Anytime this tool has gotten this oversold here, here, and here, this is a bounce that always comes, and we talked about this in the last videos. So the bounce was natural due to it, and let's take a look at the volumes. The volumes were very low today compared to Friday, because Friday was option expiration day, and naturally the volumes are higher. So the volume was tad lower here for McKellen, for the market, and it does a good job here. You see the same pattern here on these. All the stocks that we have here are kind of damaged, but look at Apple. This stock managed to tag on a lot of points. And where's Apple here? Come on, we can't wait. Okay, 30 points. And look at this channel here. This is beautiful. This is a nicely carved channel. We hit that bottom and then we broke out from this pattern. And when we're breaking out, the volume was decent, 22 million shares. And I'm just going to change the studies to 200-day stochastics, 200-day moving average and stochastic. You can see this is an entry level here. The entry level traders are jumping and piling in here today, and that's what drove this stock up here to 561. We have resistance up here at 571. If we get there, we may close our position temporarily, because this could just bob up and down here and give some headaches for a little bit. I could be wrong, but you never know what the resistance will do tomorrow, how much buyers are there, and what kind of market conditions there. PCLN, the other stock here, I'm going to cover this very quickly, also did a nice turnaround at about 25 points, but nothing to match the great Apple. And a lot of other stocks are in the same boat here. They're just trying to get out from this oversold conditions.